just gonna play me some pinball arcade. And throughout the stream, I'm gonna have me a peanut butter sandwich and a Reese's peanut butter egg. So let me get these crummy things on. Okay, let me get this screen off. Alright. Okay, for those that have never seen me stream this game before, typically I play random tables. And unless I have a good reason for doing so, I don't play the same one twice. I do take requests, but again, I ask that please don't request something that I've already played before. So, I have over 100 tables, so there's not really a whole lot of point in playing the same one over and over and over and over again. So, that being said, here we go. Jaxel, big shot. Oh, I gotta fix this. One of my favorite tables right here. Super simple theme to it. Just take down all the drop targets. Thought I was gonna bounce off the flipper, but apparently not. About to do it again. Oh! Just barely caught that slingshot. Now this is where you really want to take down the targets. Your first three balls, each target nets you 1,000. Ball four, 2,000. This one, 3,000. So. Much for that.
systems go commence countdown.
Space 2000, or Flight 2000, I mean.
Prepare for
fast table right here. Basically, unlight all the lights. Lock three balls. You. But, like I was saying, unlight the lights, lock three balls, take down these drop targets in reverse order from 5 to 1. And then, once you've done all that, multi-ball starts. Or in the meantime, keep aiming for these drop targets because it increases the value of the spinner. You get the spinner value way up there, this is going to become a prime target right here. Hitting this target here increases the multiplier. Jeez, man. Much for that. One of my favorite tables right here. Enter Xena. And kind of like Central Park, nudging the table is very important on this one. And getting it in the upper play field as well. We have the best drop targets in all of pinball right here. They're super mushy. You can do big time sweeps. You can do bank sweeps. Little white rollovers correspond to the drop targets. Thank you. Maybe you should have made this four player. Holy fuck. Okay, get in that hole three times, that'll... But it's locked, not that it matters, because the ball fucking drained. Hang on, I messed up. Yep. Basically, this table here, hit what's lit. And note the lower right corner. It's got a rather unique out lane. Means catching the ball can be a dangerous proposition. Do it to this one too. Oh. Yeah. It's a big old wide gap. Oh, did it again. Fuck off. I'm trying to catch the ball, not bounce it like that. Okay, Centaur. This table here, you're gonna find me playing more of a sniper role. These targets here, taking them down locks the ball, but if you can take them down in order, it'll release that ball for multi-ball. Otherwise, failing that, if you take down these drop targets and hit the target behind it, it starts multi-ball. Lighting up all four of these will start multi-ball. Taking down these targets in order, I don't know what that does. I'm guessing it might have something to do with this shoot back here. I think if you hit this when it's lit and you have a ball locked, it'll also start multi-ball.
Bad movement.
Alright, I'm... Captain Ball in the upper left. If you can shoot it through here, you get double whatever's lit here. So whenever you hear the guy say, "Only single value," that's what he means. 43 viewers? Oh! This happened yesterday too when I was streaming Grim Dawn. I think somebody's hosting me. This way, I'd have gotten doubled. Not try to hit the S target. Nope. Okay. But yeah, like I said, I had the same thing happen yesterday too. I think it was like 30, either 30 or 80 on at once. Might be a bug unless I'm going to have 56 viewers that are going to introduce themselves.
Only single value.
Damn. There we go. Two ball, multi ball. Three ball, multi ball. Should have been.
Release power.
Once upon a time, I knew. Once upon a time, I. Hang on. The mini loop on the far left, once upon a time, I used to be able to hit that shot consistently. I don't know what happened now.
Thank you.
There it is. Went right by me. Oh. I forgot they're all set up. That's a good first ball. That's a good ball right there. And, on top of that, this table also has a milestone system. For every 20,000 bonus you get, it saves it. I managed to get it all the way up to 60. So from here on out, for the rest of the game, this is what I'm gonna have. Since I did such a good ball, these other three players, I'm just gonna let the balls rain on them. The only reason I had the other three players on here was for just insurance. I want to say it was 7 or 8 million. Missed it.
2x completed.
Draining them. Got it. Just need to get that last target. just letting the balls drain on the other three. I accomplished what I wanted with player one. Playing number two. Playing number two, skipping three and four. Gotta hit the S. It releases power. Nope. Fun while it lasted. Monster Bash.
It's alive!
The table overall is cool, except for the voice acting. Oh my god, is it freaking annoying.
Welcome to the Monster Bash!
I'm scared of the moon!
I'm scared of the moon!
You don't understand!
I'll change!
I hope this monster is
And with this table here, ideally, you want to start all the modes at the same time. With the multi-ball one last. You don't want to start one at a time. I gotta make the loop as many times as possible now. Basically, what you want to do when you start a mode, you have to get a whole bunch of points during that mode. And when you do, you'll get their instrument as well. So when you start up, I think it's Monster Bash Multiball. If you have all the instruments collected, you'll get like a huge bonus. And plus, I think each jackpot you get during that multiball gives you max points. like, I want to say 10 million.
No, please, not the moon!
Come on, Gil!
La la!
Whoops.
Whoops.
Not what I wanted.
Yes, Master! He will be the greatest rocket player ever! It's alive!
Super Tank!
Amen! Oh, that went right by me.
Jackpot! Double super jackpot!
Other brights pale by comparison.
Oh, that's Mummy Mayhem. I might have gotten an extra ball, too.
You guys talk funny.
Mummy Mayhem, ideally you want to aim for the bumpers.
Blah! Good evening. Let's boogie! Extra
ball! Hey, Slick, move your teeth. I can't see the ball. I'm too old for this! Whoa!
Give me that wicked little band!
All together!
Hey! Watch the family jewels!
Extra ball! I got his instrument.
Can I get some fries with that steak? Come on, Gil. Nobody knows the scales like you.
Yeah, I already used it. All the instruments.
Hello, Transylvania! Let's rock!
Let's go.
Single file down the frickin' middle.
I just love that minty.
Here's some aldehyde flavor.
Let me fetch my sticks!
Yeah, no kidding.
Shoot again.
Hardly much point having that many balls for multi-ball. I think the absolute most you should have is maybe three. Cause you got like six or eight balls out there, you're just gonna spend most of your time hitting the other balls than you are actually hitting targets. And yeah, believe it or not, the high score is mine.
Don't move!
Fuck all! I think that table there costs, I think it costs like a couple bucks at the bowling alley I go to once in a very, very, very great while. Rip off.
Coming through!
This version here is way better than the one on FX3.
Let's wreck some road!
Too much.
Tuesday! Wednesday!
Wasn't supposed to do that.
Hey, look, Taz, taxi cabs!
You will remove that bulldozer from the street!
Yeah.
Is that bothering you, darling?
Yeehaw!
I am not afraid of you! You have not heard the last of
Yeehaw!
Back to work.
Back to work.
Away, baby.
Hey, watch where you're going. Oh, my.
There we go.
Where are we?
Friday! Quitting time.
Where's my paycheck? Where's my paycheck?
That's what I'm aiming for.
Where's my...
Payday! Put on your dancing shoes, baby!
Put on your dancing shoes, baby!
Oh, just barely. That's a deceptively hard skill shot to hit.
Hey, look, kid! Mardi Gras!
I knew I should have brought more than one t-shirt.
Jerk alert. There's an actual skill shot here, too.
Oh, no! Fire in the hole!
Got it.
It's a dud. Great shot.
Stick a fork in me, baby. I'm done.
And I forgot what I had to do for multi-ball.
You big dummy.
Guess it was that. Ball's lit.
Stand by for blasting. You look like an
extra ball.
Not one, but two. Got it. Don't think that counts as an extra ball. Oh, thanks, Katara.
The storm is coming. Return to your homes.
Too much. Crap out of her now.
Hey, watch where you're shooting, buddy.
Let's get on down the bombs.
Hey, let's get a souvenir. Thursday. Hey, that's neat.
For that ramp.
We're eating half a hog tonight. I'm on easy street tonight.
Boom!
You know, I gotta aim for that hole.
Party!
Fire in the hole! Nice shot! Look, Ted, go! Fire in the hole! Hey, stop!
Nope. Out there. Ah. Damn it. Should have hit when I had the chance.
Big point.
Stupid.
Not enough mustard in that hot dog.
Baby!
Hey, Dave!
Oh, put a fork in me, baby. I'm done.
Party time!
I'm shutting down.
Oh, no.
I keep forgetting I gotta aim for the mouth. Thank you.
The biggest bang for your buck, baby.
Hey! Spin the wheel!
Lunch time. Get yourself a hot dog. And yeah, I believe the high score is mine.
Where's my paycheck?
Pipe down.
Hey,
hey! Put on your dancing shoes, baby.
Put on your dancing shoes, baby.
Oh, not enough. Oh, fucking knock it off.
Big point. Hot shoot.
Titans!
And same thing here, because I like this table, and considering I haven't had much luck with any of the others except maybe Red and Ted's, just kind of set it to four player. If I do really good on one player, I'll just let the ball drain on the other three. But generally speaking, this table,
go for the tunnel.
Hit what's lit. Or I should say, hit what's flashing. Found power one.
Found power one.
Found power two.
Found power two.
Try to hit that far left passageway.
The tunnel.
Nudge, Joe.
to the tunnel.
The shot's lit. Not gonna hit. I would say it's a good thing I set this to four player.
Go for the tunnel.
Lion Man! Lion Man!
Said, I'm trying to hit that area at the far left. But because it's lit, I'm not hitting. Which lucky player is going to be able to start multi-ball here? My god, it was player two. Trying to lock the balls.
Found power one.
Found power one.
Found power two.
Found power two.
Multi-ball, I believe you have to take down the drop targets at the very upper left part of the table. The one that's flashing. Starting to actually make that shot now.
Found power one. Thank you.
second ball is locked.
Lion Man! Lion Man!
Get up there. Okay.
Freeze the titan.
Got extra ball. I thought I got jackpot. Whoop. Not what I wanted the ball to do. There we go.
Lion Man defeats the Balrog.
I think I might have flipped the score. Yeah, I flipped the score.
Ooh.
one.
Yeah, I'm thinking I have it. I don't recall me ever flipping a score on this table. Should be extra ball. Yep. Try to get in the upper play field, get the flashing drop target, that scores your jackpot. I think I have to aim for that ramp. Spoiler look green. Just gonna let the balls drain on the others. State, the big goal, get in the upper play field and hit the flashing drop target. There should have been extra ball.
Ah!
Went right by me.
Lion Man!
Whenever you hear that guy say, Lion Man, Lion Man, that means there's a hurry up at the back ramp. And it's one of the harder ones to get to because you only have 3 seconds to get it. Much for that. Now let's hope I don't mess with the initials. Night Joe. Seems this ain't the only time. Okay. I guess this wasn't the only time I flipped the score. $15 million. Yeah, thank you, Kitaro. Actually, let me,
Free the Titans!
Okay, I'm, trying to get my paint program up. Don't seem to be working. I want to do this now.
Come on. Okay. All right, so I got that. Probably gonna be my last table, too. Again, I gotta go grocery shopping to buy shit that I forgot to buy yesterday. No. Yeah. Twice. Got it. See, this is really what I'm aiming for, loops. And that. Thank you. Schmoe should be awake, yep. Yeah. Yep. Spot. Fuck that up. Yeah, that's my take on this session, too. Turn to shit in a hurry. Twice. Nope. Extra ball is lit. Perfect. Oh, and up. here. I'll explain the jackpot here later. But pretty much my goal now is just to keep hitting the loops. Just gonna let the ball drain on player one. Kind of a weird quirky carom there. Twice. Got it. Come on, get over. Oh, didn't register. Lucky. First one. Yeah, extra ball lit. Yeah, I don't really care for the second one at all. The only time I play it is if it comes up as a random table in here, or if I have to play it for a league or a tournament on Pinball FX3. Got it.
Plus, because, because it plays songs like LaGrange by ZZ Top and, like, other tunes, too, it's actually copyrighted music. I wouldn't be able to export the video to YouTube if that was on there, because otherwise my whole entire video will get flagged and they'll start putting ads on it. Despite the fact that it's just digitized music on a pinball machine, YouTube will still flag it anyway. So, on Pinball Arcade, more often than not, if the table comes up, I skip it. Now on Pinball FX3, you can turn off the copyrighted music, but you're gonna be playing with a lot of silent tables. Because at least half the tables on there have copyrighted music on it. Twice.
Nope.
Gotta make that ram shot two times in a row. I wanted to. Oh hell, I still gotta keep hitting ram shots. I gotta get the multiplier up. That's the beauty of these, of making these loops. When they're lit, you can hit them either way. You can either hit them, you can hit the lip loop this way, or you can hit them from behind too. So, and even then, you don't have to fly through it at high speed. Just barely enough for the sign thingy to go over one revolution. And extra balls lit again. High speed 2, they basically tried to improve on perfection. And they ended up failing. I'm thinking one of the reasons why high speed is such a great table is because they created a high speed 2, which basically sucked. So, that just made this table here look a lot better. But it also ended up making Williams look pretty bad in the process. Sorry if that doesn't make sense. It just made sense when it came out. And I'm just gonna let the ball drain on this one. Oftentimes, if I feel like I'm gonna be sucking really bad at pinball, I'll set it to 2 players, or sometimes even 4 players, if I'm really abysmal. So, but if I can do good on one of the players, I'll just let the ball drain on all the rest of them. I've accomplished what I wanted. Also, since I'm at a good stopping point right now, what I was trying to say about jackpots, 250,000 seems like a pretty small number, but just keep in mind that in real life, the jackpots carry over from game to game to game to game. It was meant to be built up over time, over a period of days or weeks or whatever. And then some lucky guy comes in, snaps up on it all. So, but since this is free play, and since I'm basically I'm better at this version than I am on the real life version, if only because you can't really nudge the tables in real life. Hell, half the time you can't even breathe on them, otherwise they tilt on you. Whereas here, I can basically turn this table into a damn milkshake. Yeah, 484. Like I said, it's supposed to be built up over a period of days or weeks or whatever. Much for that. Well, at least the extra ball still lit. And I might have beaten the high score on this one too. My high score on this is like 26 or 27 million. I think right now I have 18 million. I'm trying to aim for that extra ball. Ah! There we go. But also, keep in mind too that you probably don't know this, but I've been playing Pinball Arcade for upwards of 3 years now. So I put in a lot of time on these tables.
I know most, if not all, the quirks. I think it double dipped there. I got two ramp shots for the price of one. Twice. Got it. Much for that. Like I said, with those loops, you don't even have to like fly through them. You can just barely touch them. Twice, there we go. Suspect got multi-ball. One way to do it, I guess. I'll wait for all the commotion to die down. Payment for the loops. Extra ball should be lit. Nope, one more. And it goes on anyway. double score. I'm thinking I got another extra ball. That there is one of the reasons why I set this on two player. But I don't think I beat my high score. I think I got a 21 million. Alrighty, well, that's gonna do it for me. I gotta shut it on. I gotta do some grocery shopping. I gotta buy some stuff that I forgot to buy yesterday. So, that's all, folks. But otherwise, thanks for coming, everybody. I appreciate it. And I should be on roughly 4 p.m., if not sooner. And I will be streaming Final Fantasy 14. And if I get done with that, if I get done doing all the things I want to do on that game, I might switch over and play some Grimdawn. But we'll see come tomorrow afternoon / evening. But until then, thanks again for coming, everybody, and see you all next time. And good meeting you, Vectronics.